Hello guys, welcome to Freebirds Crew. This is our new project that is based on Quick Draw. A Quick Draw is a doodle recognition system that helps you to recognize the incomplete, messy, or the images that are made just in a one go, or the images that are non-understandable images. So with the help of this, you can understand that. So before starting the project, please like, subscribe, and share our YouTube channel so that you can get a new video whenever it uploads on our YouTube channel. So let's start it. In this project, I will totally explain about all the features of Quick Draw, what is Google's Quick Draw, how it works, its architecture, the convolutional layers, the pooling layers, the activation functions, and everything about that. So just be with it and watch the whole video to get to know about it. So let's start. So this is Google's Quick Draw. A Google's Quick Draw works in a way that it can give you a name of object and you have to draw it. While you're drawing that object, it can just keep guessing. Like you draw a line, it can say it's a line. When you draw a square, it can say it's a book, it's a cover, it's a anything like that. So I will show you how it works really. As you see, here it gives you a passport and you draw a line, it says line, it says driving board, it says square, it says book, it says bread, and at times it says I don't know about it, but it keeps guessing, and at last it can give you the right answer that it's a passport. It is how it works. Like you just keep guessing on each and every line or each and every pen up you can do. So in this way Google's Quick Draw works. So the next thing is its architecture. The architecture of the Quick Draw is based on the convolutional neural network, that is CNN. It is based on the convolutional layers that may be 1D, 2D or 3D, and as well as pooling, it also be 1D, 2D and 3D, and the activation functions like ReLU, Sigmoid and many more functions are there. So this is how it works. It can just get a bunch of images. And just like we give him an image like this tree, it can just pass down this image through the convolutional layers, pooling layers, activation functions, and can predict the answer. It's a tree. So this is how it simple. It's not a very complex thing. It's a very much simple project that is Quick Draw. So let's make it more interesting by explaining its activation functions. Activation function is nothing like but a function that helps you to get a output from one layer and feed that output as the input to the other layer. Like it can just work like this and this. It can just go from this layer to this layer in a very particular value or a specific value, like the ReLU. The ReLU is a rectified linear unit. It is a non-linear activation function that is used because it does not activate all the neurons at one time. It just only activate when it needs, or whenever the value is less than zero, it just deactivate that neuron because it is no need of there, and it can save your time or your complexity of the model. And the softmax is also a non-linear activation function. It can gives you output between 0 and 1, like just the probability case, because probability is always between 0 and 1. So with the help of that, you can just recognize the pattern of the data or pattern of the record that been sent to you or sent to your model. So the next thing is the architecture of the CNN architecture. Like in this project, I will build a architecture like this. This is my model that I build in this project. Like it has 3 convolutional 2D layers and 3 max pooling 2D layers, and after that it flattens into a vector, like a simple vector, and that vector is feed in as an input to the fully connected layers or the dense layers that predicts the probabilities of that image, that this image matches with which label that the model is trained on. Like the model is trained on many images. Like I just feed the image of an umbrella. So it starts from the convolutional layer that extracts the features of that umbrella, its pixels, its size, its its colors and everything. And then the pooling layer. The pooling layer optimizes that features, because we do not need all the features of image, we just need the important feature. So it can optimize the feature and can use the dimensionality reduction on that features, and can just carry the important features, and that important features are go to the fully connected layer that helps us to predict what it look like that the model is trained on. So now let's start with the working project. Our working project is as simple as much. It is not a very very much big project or very much complex project. It is very simple. You can learn it by just in one go, because I can make it so simple for you. So let's start it now. So guys, this is the project that I made with the help of Google Colab, because the data is very huge amount of data, so it is not easy to process with my own personal laptop. So I can use this Google Colab to process this huge amount of data. So to first I can get the file that is mini classes, that contains the files related to all the objects. In this file approximately there are 100 objects that are of umbrella, apple, candle, and that each object contain the NumPy array of the image, like image pixels, like the NumPy array of image pixels in that each and every object of a particular thing. And now let's start. I can drums.numpy, sun.numpy, laptop.numpy. So it can just contain all the numpy arrays of each object. As I repeat, it can contain the numpy arrays. It does not contain anything like the images or that. It can just the numpy arrays. So as it downloads, I will tell you about these functions. So in this type, I will just input the Keras version 2.3.0, NumPy version this, Delphi version this. So you can just install all the latest versions about all your libraries, because I see there are many projects that are supported with the older libraries, but as soon as the new library comes, your project just goes off. So this project is not like that. You can just go with it and can make a real difference with it. So as it downloads, it can take some time. So as our downloading is complete now, so we can just go for the further step. These are the libraries that I used for that modeling. So I can just run it. And these are the versions of our Keras, NumPy and TensorFlow. You can just use the latest version like that. Let's load the data. To load the data, I can just manipulate the data. It's like each class contained the different number of samples of array stored as NPY format, since we have to have some memory limitations. So you can only load 5000 images per class. Like if I can load more than 5000 images, so my RAM will consume all and this Google Colab notebook will collapse. So I can just limit my images per class. So like I can use 4000 here and just run that function. So this function is just not like anything complex thing. It can got all the NPY functions and can just make the initials. Like this is the X and Y NumPy arrays of this rows and this columns and the class names, and then load each file. Like from each file, like the each file has index and value. So the IDX and file index value pair, we can just make it like that. So this can load the file and then just make it in like from at the zero index you can got this, you can for one index you can got this value. So just we can make a like a dictionary thing like that simply. So we can just concatenate all, and then y, this x axis, y axis, you know that guys, you can make a graph of that so you can get it fully. So this is the class name and the names of the class, like apple, umbrella, lantern, car, book, or anything else. And then you can just randomize dataset, because the randomized dataset has higher probability to get a true value and it has higher accuracy. And then separate into a test and training. You can just partialize the dataset into 80-20 or 70-30 ratio. So I can here change it into like this. So I can just called it X test, V test, and this function returns at the end of this. You can just run it now, and with the help of that, I can just load all my data in these all variables. So this thing can take some time to train on, because as you see, when I just run this thing, my RAM consumption increasing here. So to make this type of objects, you need a higher computation power or higher RAM or disk to storage, because it needs to process a lot amount of data. As I will tell you here, it has limitation for only 5000 images per class, because this Google Colab notebook gives me only 12 point something about RAM, because that RAM I can just consume only for the 5000 images per class. But if I have the more RAM or more memory, then I can process I think more than 5000 images or about 10000 images at that time. So it's all depend upon the computation power that we used in the project. So as this line of code is processing, I will tell you about what I am doing here. So I'm doing here, like I can just import the matplotlib library and the random function. The random function is used to just randomly pick any images from the dataset, and can just with the help of matplotlib, you can just show here. Like again from the x-train, it can just randomly show any year in the size of 2828 and with the class name. So that type of thing, I can show the image. So but at a time it does not predict. It predicts only when we bring a model, and we can train a model on that. So guys, as our model is trained now, so after the model training, I can just print the length of the our X train, and you see it is 3320,000. So it is so much length. So that's why I am saying ki our model is a very huge amount of data, so it cannot process with just 12 GB of RAM. So after that, I can show you the random image from the set like this. So this image is can predict by our model now. So like we have to just reshape or normalize our model into a float type, because float type is a continuous data. We need a continuous data of each and every bit. So that's why we have to reshape our, normalize our model with respect to our model. So like this is happen.
So this I reshape the X-train as its shape, size and image size, and then convert into the float, same as X-test into the float, and then this model should divide by 255 because there are 256, like what are the pixel rate or pixel bit per rate, that type of things. So now this is our model. This model needs to be very precise. You can just do hit and trial method to build a model that gives you a high accuracy. So as this model is made up with the Keras library, it is a sequential model, like it can do work by sequence by sequence. So as you see my model structure, I can made a convolutional layer at this place and then a max pooling, and then again convolutional, again max pooling, again convolutional, again max pooling, because the layer by layer my features are more accurate and my features are more extracted from the data. Because as you see, if I put this image into this model, so this layer extract the feature, and this can optimize it, and that optimization is again extracted by this model, again optimize, again extract, again optimize. So it is so optimized that you can get a very accurate result, up to accuracy of above 90%. So after that, I can just flatten to convert it into a vector form, and then I can just put it into the fully connected layer to predict the probability, like which image is this according to the label. So as I use here the ReLU or softmax function, because the output of ReLU is in input of softmax, and it gives the probability of 0 and 1. So between the probability, it gives you the output. Like if the probability of this image is different for different things, like it is a bicycle, but there are different types of probabilities, like remote control, like anything like that. So the probability of bicycle is 0.8, and probability of remote control is 0.6. So it can predict like of probability which has the higher probability. Like this is the optimizer. I can use the Adam optimizer. So this way I can just compile my model and click on the summary. As you see, these are just the simple coding things. As when you go on the official site of a convolutional model, you can just see there, and these are just to make your model more precise and more accurate. So as you see, these are the images, and this is the parameter set takes, max pooling takes, the ML. As you see, our frame size is increased layer by layer, as our parameter is also increased layer by layer. So in this way, you can get a very accurate result at every time. So we just have to just fit our model with our data. And I used approaches, 5 approaches, 5 iterations. So you can train on all the 5 approaches. You can train just one by one. As you see, our RAM is consumed around 1.46 gigabytes. The one approach is done, and it has accuracy of 87%. So approach by approach, your accuracy will increase 87%, 90%, and after the 3, it again increase at some point. So after 3rd is 91%, because when your model is precise and when your all the data is correctly pre-processed and cleaned, your model accuracy will always increase. Because as I explained in my previous project, that do more time in data cleaning and pre-processing. So at night, at rest, it can 91.19%. So I'm check the accuracy now. Accuracy is 91.93%. So it's correct. And now we just have to predict and name our model. Like this thing can just randomly pick pick up an image and show to us like this image. So this our model, model.predict function, has to predict what is it. It's a cell phone. And it also a paper clip, pencil, sock or traffic light. So the most probability is cell phone. So it just do the cell phone at the first place. And if you can run it again, you can just again show you another thing. Like I think it's a knife. So it can, I think it's a pretty knife. It's a sword. Yes, it's also a sword, broom, knife, scissors and star. So in this way it can predict with the very much good accuracy. So after that we just have to save our model and we want to use it on our another project. So we can just do it by like this. We can just save all the classes here. You can install this pip install TensorFlow.js if you are a JavaScript developer. So in this way it is installed here, and now you can just save your model in a h5 file. Like I can save my model here, it is saving. Okay, so it's done, I think. Yes, it's done. So our model is also saved, and now we can create just a model folder, and then we can convert our Keras into the model with the help of this we installed. Now we just have to copy all the files here, and then just have download our model. So in this way I can download our model on my machine. As you see, it downloads. So this is our whole project that is totally based on the quick draw feature. As you see, we can just show him an image and it can just predict it. Every time when a image is given to him, this model, it can predict it very very accurate with 91% accuracy. That is very high accuracy. So this is all from my side. So I hope you like this video. If you like this video, please like, subscribe and share our channel, because we can make more and more new interesting projects that on interesting technologies. So please be with it and stay with us, because we learn and grow together. So thank you guys, thank you so much.